Today we are tackling one of the most ignored settings in Bambu Studio that could literally save your hours on every single print. It's called Max Volumetric Speed, or as I like to call it, the Flow Rate Governor. And I bet most of you either ignore it completely or have no idea what it actually does. But here is the thing, misunderstanding this one setting could be a difference between printing a lampshade in 3.5 hours versus 5.2 hours using the exact same amount of filament. And if you're running a 3D printing business or side hustle, this setting could literally double your daily output and increase profits. Let me start something super simple. Imagine you're pouring honey through a funnel. You can tilt it, angle it, pour it faster or slower, but no matter what you do, that funnel has only one limit. You can't push more honey through it than the funnel physically allows, right? That's exactly what max volumetric speed is. Your hot end is the funnel. The melted plastic is the honey. And if you try to force too much through too fast, well, things get sticky. Literally. Now, most people think about 3D printer speed only in terms of millimeter per seconds. You know, 200-300 mms. That's fast the nozzle moves across the bed. But here is what we are missing. Moving fast doesn't mean anything if the hot end can't keep up with melting the plastic fast enough to extrude it. That's where the volumetric speed comes in. It's measured in a cubic millimeter per second, same as the other speeds. And it answers one simple question: how much plastic by volume can your hot end actually melt and push out per second? The same hot end can extrude way more plastic if you're using thick lines and bigger layers versus thin lines and delicate layers. The speed stays the same on paper, but the volume totally different, and that's what max volumetric speed controls. Alright, let's do the math. Don't worry, it's actually super simple. The formula is volumetric speed equals layer height multiplied by layer width multiplied by print speed. That's it, all in millimeter and millimeter per second. Let me give you a quick example. Say you are using a standard 0.4 mm nozzle with these settings: layer height 0.2, layer width 0.45, print speed 200 mms. So volumetric speed would be 0.2 multiplied by 0.45 multiplied by 200 equals 18 mms. Easy, right? Now let's see what this looks like in the real world with this lampshade. Okay, so I printed this lampshade on my Bambu Lab A1 mini with some aggressive settings, and this is where volumetric speed actually matters in real life. Here's exactly what I said: nozzle 0.4 mm, line width 0.8, layer height 0.28, outer layer print speed 200 mms, max volumetric speed 27 mms. Let me calculate the actual volumetric speed needed. 0.28 multiplied 0.8 multiplied 200 equals 44.8 mms. Now here is where it gets interesting. I need 44.8 mm to print at these settings, but I set max to only 27 mm. Why? Because Bambu Lab officially recommend around 21 mm for their stock hot end with generic PLA. I'm pushing a little higher, 27, but still within a reasonable safety margins. Any higher, I'm risking hot end stress. So what did Slicer do? It did the math backward. If max is 27, layer height is 0.28 and the line width is 0.8, then the print speed must be 27 divided by 0.28 into 0.8, roughly 120 mm, not the 200 mm I set. So even though I set 200 mm in my profile, the printer actually ran slower to stay within the volumetric limit. And you know what? That's perfect. Because the A1 mini stock hot end literally cannot handle 44.8 mm reliably with PLA. It would choke, and I do get under extrusion, weak layers, gaps, and probably a failed print. But because I set that 27 mm limit, the slicer protected me. Here's the comparison: same lampshade, three different volumetric speed settings. Scenario 1, conservative. Max volumetric speed set 12 mm. Actual print speed 54 mm. Print time 5 hours 27 minutes. Excellent quality, super safe, but takes lot of time. Scenario 2, optimize. This is what I did. Max volumetric speed set 27 mm. Actual print speed 12 mm. Print time 3 hours 33 minutes. Result: solid quality, great speed. Scenario 3, too aggressive. Max volumetric speed set 44.8 mm. Actual print speed 220 mm. Print time 3 hours 21 minutes. Result might be under extrusion, weak layers, possible mechanical stress. See how scenario 1 takes almost 2 hours longer. And scenario 3 saves only 12 minutes but risk quality and hardware. Scenario 2 is a sweet spot, fast enough to be practical, safe enough to be reliable. By understanding volumetric speed, I cut my print time in half compared to conservative settings without sacrificing quality. Important note, there are also high flow nozzles available from companies like Bambu Lab, Slice Engineering and others that can unlock even higher volumetric speeds. But for now, let's focus on the stock setup. Now here is where this gets really interesting, especially if you're selling prints or running 3D printing side hustle. Say you are printing and selling products like this lampshade. With these settings, 0.8 line width, 0.28 layer height and max volumetric speed of 12 mms, then print takes 5 hours 27 minutes. But by tuning the max volumetric speed to 27 mms, it only takes 3.5 hours. Interesting, right? That's 2.5 hours saved per print. Look at the difference. Scenario 1, slow settings. You can print 4 lampshades per day. Scenario 2, optimized settings, 6 to 7 lampshades per day. That's an extra 2 prints from one printer just by understanding one setting, not buying second printer. And this applies to any product you are printing. Plantner, Dex Organizer, Miniature, Cosplay Helmets and functional parts. The faster you print without sacrificing quality, the more units you produce and higher your profit margin climbs. So if you're serious about making money with 3D printing, learning max volumetric speed isn't optional. It's essential for your business. Alright, two big mistakes we need to avoid. Mistake 1, ignoring volumetric speed. You see someone online printing at 300 mms and think, I want that speed. So you cranked it up to 300 mms. But you never set a max volumetric speed. What happens? Either the slicer slows you down automatically and defeating the purpose, or worse, your hot end tries to keep up and you get under extrusion, gaps in your layers and failed prints. It's like stepping on the gas in a car with no brakes. Mistake 2, using thick line widths without adjusting max volumetric speed. A 0.8 mm line width is amazing for speed and strength. Thick and chunky layers that print fast, yes please, but if your volumetric limit is too low, like 12 mms, your printer crawls because it can't extrude fast enough. You lose the entire speed advantage. It's like trying to drive a sports car in a second gear. Now everyone asks me, okay Siddhish, what should my max volumetric speed actually be? Honest answer, you have to test it. Every hot end is slightly different. Every filament behaves differently at different temperature. Temperature, nozzle condition, filament quality, it all matters. Here is how to do it safely. Before we start, adjust your layer height and line width based on your part's needs. If you don't need super fine details, increase both. More extrusion volume per second means faster printing. Write down what works for your design. Step 1, start conservative. For generic PLA on a stock bamboo hot end, start with 15 to 18 mms. For PTG, go lower 8 to 10 mms. These are safe starting points. Step 2, print a test part. Take a small cube and watch it print. Look at the layers. Are they consistent? Do you see any gaps or weird blobs? Is the extrusion smooth and uniform? There are preloaded G-code test files available online that are specially designed for finding your printer's volumetric speed limits. Download one and test with it. They take the guesswork out and help you find the perfect speed without compromising quality. Step 3, gradually increase. If it looks good, bump the volumetric speed by 2-3% and print another part. Keep going until you notice under extrusion, thinner walls, gaps between lines or nozzle skipping steps. That's your red flag. Back off slightly. Once you find the limit, dial it back. That's your safe maximum for the filament type and for your machine also. For reference, Bambu Lab officially rate their stock hot end at around 21 mms for generic PLA. In real world testing, by users like me, some hot ends push to 27 mms with good results, while some users struggle at 20 mms. It depends on temperature, nozzle wear, filament brand, even ambient humidity. The A1 I use for the lampshade, I can run at 27 mms without any major issues. But to be extra safe, Bambu Lab recommends 21 mms. Important insight, the bigger your part, the bigger the nozzle size and thicker your layer height and line width, the huge the impact of optimizing volumetric speed becomes. Literally save hours without compromising quality at all. This is why understanding these settings is so powerful for production printing. Okay, actionable steps right now. Here is how to set this up in Bambu Studio. Decide on your layer height, line width, and print speed based on what you are printing. Second, calculate your volumetric speed. Use the formula layer height multiplied by layer width multiplied by print speed. Step 3. Compare your hotend's limit. If your calculated volumetric speed exceeds your hotend's safe max, you need to adjust as per. Step 4. Set it in the slicer. In Bambu Studio, go to the filament settings, filament, max volumetric speed, and enter your safe value. The slicer will automatically throttle your print speed to stay under that limit. Save different profiles for each filament type. PLA works at 21 mm, PTG 10 mm, and so on. Then you just need to switch profiles and you're good to go. One more thing, adjusting volumetric speed is powerful, but it's not magic. Push it too high and you will see under extrusion or mechanical stress. Too low and you're leaving speed on the table. Find the sweet spot for your specific hot end and filament. So let's recap what happened with the lampshade. Settings: 0.4 nozzle, 0.8 line width, 0.28 layer height, max volumetric speed 27 mm, print time 3 hours 33 minutes, filament use 251 grams. The theoretically volumetric speed needed was 44.8 mm, but I kept it at 27. The slicer automatically dropped the speed from 200 mm to around 12 mm to stay safe. Result: a solid quality print in 3.5 hours instead of 5.2 hours. If I do use conservative settings, same print would have taken 5.2 hours. If I do try to max it out, it do risk under extrusion or hardware stress for only 12 minutes save. Not worth it. The sweet spot 27 mm, but for safer side, make it 21 mm. Fast, reliable, and profitable. Key takeaway: max volumetric speed is a hidden bottleneck most people ignore. Understand it, testing it, and optimizing it unlocks your printer's true potential, whether you are printing as a hobby or running a business. If this video helped you, please smash that like button. It helps the YouTube algorithm and supports the channel. Subscribe for more deep dives in 3D printers, 3D printing business strategies, and creative projects. Drop a comment down below if you have any query. If you're selling a 3D prints or running a side hustle, I have an affordable commercial license for 3D models to help you level up your business. Check out my Patreon, link in the description. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Happy printing.